Good morning, students. Today in this class, we will discuss about the topic of the atomic structure, that is valency. Okay? What is valency? Now, valency can be defined as number of electrons accepted or donated by an atom during a chemical reaction. It's called its valency. Okay? For example, sodium and chlorine. Atomic number of sodium is 11 and atomic number of chlorine is 17. That means electronic configuration of sodium is 2, 8, 1, and electronic configurations for chlorine is 2, 8, 7. Okay? That means in the first orbit of the sodium, 2 electrons are present. In the second orbit, 8 electrons are accommodated, and the left 1 electron is accommodated in the last orbit, that is M orbit. That means in the valence shell or last orbit of the sodium, only 1 electron is present. Okay? On the other hand, in chlorine atom, in first orbit 2 electrons are present or accommodated. In the second orbit, 8 electrons are accommodated. Maximum number of electrons can be accommodated in the second orbit, that is 8. And the left 7 electrons is accommodated in the third orbit, that is M orbit of the chlorine. Okay, that means 7 electrons, last 7 electrons are accommodated in the last orbit of the chlorine, that is M orbit. Clear? Now, we all know that most of the atom of the elements are not stable in the nature. Okay, but they try to attain their stability. How? Now, by taking part in chemical reactions. And when they're taking part in chemical reactions, they either accept electrons or donate electrons so that they can fulfill their duplets or octets. Because duplets and octets are the main eligibility of having or capability of physical existence or natural existence. So in that case of sodium, now in the last cell, only 1 electron is present. Okay, to attain its stability, it should have 8 electrons in their last orbit. That is according to the law of octet. Okay, according to the law of octet, an atom should have 8 electrons in their last orbit to achieve stability. Exception, now hydrogen and helium, because in the case of hydrogen and helium, only 1 orbit is present, and according to the Bode-Berry scheme, we can accommodate maximum 2 number of electrons. Okay, so in the case of helium and sodium, now if helium and sodium complete their duplet, they attain their stability. But in other cases, for other elements, which all elements try to achieve their octets or fulfill their octets so that they can achieve their stability. So in the case of sodium, only 1 electron is present in its last orbit or valence shell. Okay, that means it needs 7 more electrons to complete its octet, which is not possible for an atom to achieve such a number of elements, because electrons are bounded by a force, an electrostatic force. Okay, so sodium has other option, and that option, if sodium loses the 1 electron present in the N cell or the last cell, then its last cell become the L cell, in which already sodium had 8 electrons. So this way it can achieve the stability. So that means all the metals like sodium have the tendency to donate electrons. And in the case of sodium, sodium donate 1 electron. That means valency of sodium is 1, because sodium donate only 1 electron. On the other hand, in chlorine atom, okay, in last orbit of the chlorine atom, 7 electrons are present. That means chlorine atom needs 1 more electron to achieve the octet so that it can achieve its stability. That means it needs 1 more electron from the outside. Okay, that means it can accept 1 electron from the outside. That means its valency is also 1. Clear? So we can define Valency has the number of electron accepted or donated by an atom during a chemical reaction is called its valency. Because during chemical combinations, atoms of the elements either accept electron or donate electron so that they can fulfill their octet or duplet and achieve their stability. And that is why they produce their molecules, respective molecules. Okay? We can another way define the valency, that is combining capacity of an element, of atom of an element, with the atoms of the same origin or the dissimilar origin is also called valency. Because during chemical combination, one atom of an element can chemically combine with atoms of same origin or dissimilar origin so that they can produce their molecules and achieve their stability. For examples, now hydrogen molecule. When hydrogen molecules are formed, now when two hydrogen atoms chemically combines, they form hydrogen molecule, and in the form of molecule, hydrogen have the ability or capability of free existence in the nature. Okay, but during the formation of the molecule of H2, two hydrogen atoms are chemically combined. That means there are two hydrogen atoms are present, and each of the hydrogen atoms chemically combines with one hydrogen atom. That means combining capacity of each hydrogen atom in hydrogen molecule is 1. That means valency of hydrogen is 1. Clear? One more example. Now, a molecule of compound, water, H2O. Okay, when a water molecule forms, now when two hydrogen atoms chemically joins with one oxygen atom. Okay, that means combining capacity of oxygen is here 2, because one oxygen atom have the capacity of joining up with two hydrogen atoms. That means combining capacity of oxygen is 2. That means valency of oxygen is 2. On the other hand, two hydrogen atoms are present, and each of the hydrogen atom chemically joins with one oxygen atom. That means combining capacity of each of the hydrogen atom is 1. That means valency for hydrogen is 1. Okay, so this way we can also derive the valencies of the atoms of the elements, and we can define valency also as combining capacity of an atom of an element with the atoms of the same origin or dissimilar origin. Okay, another term that we have to discuss in this video, that is variable valency. Okay, there are some metallic elements or elements which shows more than one valency. Okay, and this phenomenon is called variable valency, because metals is capable of losing the electrons from their inner orbits also. Basically, now elements lose the electrons from their last shell, but some metals have the capacity of losing the electrons from their inner orbits too. Okay, in certain conditions. So that means with the conditions, certain metallic elements show more than one valency, and this phenomenon is called variable valency. For example, iron. Iron has 2 valencies. Okay, valency 2 and valency 3. Such as copper. Copper also shows 2 valency. Valency 1, valency 2. Okay, mercury also shows valency, 2 valencies, valency 1, valency 2. Clear? That means there are some elements which shows more than one valencies, and this phenomenon is called variable valency. Okay, that is all for this video. Have a nice day.